This video is on the topic of natural selection. The species that live around us on Earth today have not always been the same. Evidence suggests that they all share a common ancestor, a single ancestral species from which all other species have evolved or changed over time. The process by which this evolutionary change has occurred is known as natural selection, a theory first proposed by the famous Charles Darwin. Remember that evolution refers to change and that natural selection is the process by which evolution occurs. The process of natural selection involves a series of stages. In order for natural selection to occur, variation must exist between the genes of individuals in a population. It is essential to note that this variation is the result of random mutation, which does not occur in response to any factor in the environment. For example, in this moth population, some moths have alleles which code for light colour, while some have undergone random mutation to gain alleles which code for dark colour. The moth population is subject to pressures in the environment, which means that they must compete for survival. For example, there may be predators, such as birds, that will prey on moths. Some of the moths have alleles which are advantageous and which aid their survival. For example, here the dark moth is better camouflaged against tree bark, so is less likely to be eaten by predators. The dark moths are more likely to survive and reproduce, passing on alleles for dark colour. Over many generations, the dark allele becomes more common, and most of the moths in the population are dark in colour. You should learn these steps in the process of natural selection, as this topic often comes up in exam questions. This exam question presents us with an image of two species of snake with similar patterns of red and black banding on their bodies. One species, the eastern coral snake, is venomous, while the other, the scarlet kingsnake, is non-venomous. The question then asks us to explain how the kingsnake may have evolved to have a similar appearance to the coral snake. As ever, when starting to tackle an exam question, we need to note the command word, explain, and the number of marks available. Here there are 4 marks to be gained, so we need to produce an extended answer. This question is asking us to explain how a process of evolution has occurred. We know that the process by which evolution takes place is natural selection, so this question is about natural selection, and we need to apply what we know about this process to the example of the kingsnake given in the question. The first step in explaining natural selection is always to state that variation must be present. In this example, there is genetic variation in the kingsnake population. There is competition for survival. Here, the snakes compete to avoid becoming prey for larger predators. There must be an advantageous characteristic that increases survival chances. Here, the kingsnakes that have colouring that is more similar to that of the venomous coral snakes are able to deter predators, so they are more likely to survive. Survivors have increased reproduction opportunities, so the kingsnakes that look like coral snakes are more likely to reproduce. Reproduction allows advantageous alleles to be passed on. Here, the alleles for coral snake colouring are passed on. The result of this is that the advantageous characteristic of coral snake colouring becomes more common in the kingsnake population. Exam questions will often present you with an unfamiliar species to which you must be prepared to apply your knowledge of natural selection. You could perhaps use the first letters of the blue words in the commentary here, V-C-S-R-A, to come up with a memory aid to help you remember the steps. In summary, natural selection is the process by which evolutionary change can take place. In order for natural selection to occur, a population must contain genetic variation that results from random mutation. Individuals with advantageous alleles are more likely to survive, reproduce, and pass on these alleles. The advantageous alleles become more common over time, and the characteristics of the population change. Exam questions will usually ask you to apply your understanding of natural selection to unfamiliar examples, so you must learn the steps involved. Don't forget to check out all our other fantastic resources here at Save My Exams.